Welcome back to my American Shot Sizes video guide. In the previous video, I established some basic shot-related concepts and discussed standard American bird shot sizes. Now, in part 2, I'll talk a little more about the distinction between birdshot and buckshot, go over standard American buckshot sizes, and wrap up with a little bonus gift. If you haven't seen it yet, I recommend watching part 1 before continuing. This video should stand on its own for folks who have a basic understanding of shotguns, but complete newcomers should at least watch the first 3.5 minutes of part 1, which goes over the basic terms and concepts I'll build upon here. Alright, let's get going. Like birdshot, buckshot pellets are simply spherical projectiles loaded and fired manifoldly. But whereas birdshot is used on birds and other light game, larger buckshot pellets are used on medium and large creatures like, obviously, deer. For hunting, buckshot is primarily used at short ranges in locations where the much longer effective ranges of rifle bullets or shotgun slugs would present a significant collateral danger to others in the surrounding area. Buckshot's increased hit potential and substantial stopping power has also made it a popular option for close-range defense against both four- and two-legged attackers. And modern buckshot shells gained real popularity in offensive military roles during the early 1900s, soon after the first successful repeating shotguns were introduced. Now, obviously, the fundamental differences between birdshot and buckshot stem from their size. As I mentioned in the last video, there's no huge jump between birdshot and buckshot. The smallest 24 caliber buckshot is just one step above 23 caliber FF birdshot. So what makes 24 caliber so special? Well, most importantly, 24 caliber is where spherical lead projectiles at typical shotgun velocities start to have enough energy and mass to reach the vitals of large, tough creatures. Since they're essentially musket balls individually, lead pellets in this size range are roughly equivalent to lower power handgun bullets of similar size and mass. Not modern hollow points, but solid cast or full metal jacket bullets as fired from pistol-length barrels. A single 24 caliber buckshot pellet can be compared to a light 22 rimfire bullet, for instance, and larger buckshot sizes are similar to the projectiles of other small caliber cartridges. There are some differences, but mass and muzzle energy are in the same ballpark, and their wounding mechanisms are very similar. Now, low-velocity handgun FMJs are not exactly outstanding performers, and the same goes for buckshot. These simple projectiles tend to poke fairly narrow holes through a target with little permanent damage to surrounding tissues. Unless they score a direct hit to a critical structure like the heart or central nervous system, neither can be counted on to quickly and reliably incapacitate a large creature. So then why is buckshot so well known for stopping power? Well, it's simply a matter of quantity over quality. No responsible hunter would try to use a small caliber handgun loaded with FMJs to take a deer, but a single well-aimed shotgun shell can deliver the equivalent of dozens of shots with one of these, making up for the 16th century projectile technology. Another important thing about 24 caliber is that it typically marks a point where pellet counts really start to be limited by their mass and their ability to physically fit inside common shotgun shells. Pellet counts for buckshot loads are generally tens at the most, and can be as few as two or three. So while approximate numbers of birdshot pellets can be simply poured into shells by weight or volume, load consistency with buckshot requires precise numbers of pellets, and those pellets must be stacked in specific geometric arrangements in order to fit into the shell. The arrangement of spherical pellets in a cylindrical volume is actually an interesting geometric relationship that plays an important part in determining which sizes and quantities of buckshot pellets can be used in a given shot shell. I won't get into it much here, but look for a future video on the subject. This all leads to a third major distinction between birdshot and buckshot, their patterns. As I explained in the last video, birdshot is used to produce a wide cloud of pellets that is larger than the target in order to improve the chances of hitting it. This approach works because the pellet counts are in the hundreds or even thousands, while dropping a bird or breaking a clay requires only a handful of hits. It's a common misconception that buckshot can be used the same way, thanks in no small part to depictions in entertainment media. But remember that buckshot is used on targets that are much larger than birds. Since buckshot pellets can't be fired by the hundreds, a pattern larger than the target would be nowhere near dense enough to ensure a sufficient number of vital hits. So in the real world, buckshot patterns tend to be smaller than the target. An ideal group would be tight enough to make every pellet a hit with an accurate shot. Here, the pattern is less about improving the chances of hitting the target, and more about improving the chances of hitting the vitals inside the target. So, a quick recap. Birdshot pellets are fired in large quantities to create a pattern that is larger than the target. They're small and lightweight and used on things that are easy to kill but tough to hit. Buckshot pellets are fired in small numbers and tight groups. Not very useful for small or fast-moving targets, but their mass and penetration makes them very effective on larger creatures that you can draw a bead on. Alright, on to sizes. Like birdshot, American buckshot sizes are also split up between multiple naming conventions. The two primary systems are the larger Aught sizes and the smaller numbered sizes, which is where we'll start. As stated, the smallest buckshot size is 24 caliber number 4 buckshot. For those that are into airsoft, that's essentially the same size as 6mm airsoft BBs. Above number 4 buck is 25 caliber number 3 buck, 27 caliber number 2 buck, and 30 caliber number 1 buck. As with birdshot, smaller buckshot size numbers mean bigger pellets. Unlike birdshot though, the steps between these sizes vary, so there's no simple formula relating these numbers to their corresponding pellet diameters. But if you can remember that number 4 buck is 24 caliber, you can keep track of the other three by remembering that the difference between sizes increases by 1/100th of an inch each time. Now, the fact that there are numbered sizes for both birdshot and buckshot can be a source of confusion. Context aside, when the type of shot is not explicitly mentioned, it's generally assumed that the reference is to birdshot rather than buckshot. If someone says number 4 shot, 4 shot, or just number 4, they usually mean birdshot. When discussing buckshot, the size should be qualified as such, either explicitly or with an obvious shorthand. If you're trying to tell ammo apart, remember that birdshot is usually loaded and specified by weight, while buckshot loads are described by pellet count. A 1.5 ounce number 4 load is probably a birdshot shell, while a 27 pellet number 4 load must be buckshot. The numbered buckshot sizes frequently show up in the smaller gauges, where larger pellets fit poorly. Number 1 buck is common for the 16 gauge, while number 4, number 3, and number 2 buck are readily available in 20 gauge shells. But numbered buckshot is also used in larger gauges for situations where higher pellet counts are more desirable than maximum range or penetration. 12 gauge number 1 and number 4 buckshot loads especially are popular choices for personal defense and close range hunting. Buckshot sizes larger than number 1 follow a naming convention similar to the B's in birdshot, but instead of letters, zeros are used. When pronouncing these sizes aloud, a tuple of the old school Aught is proper. If you walk into a gun shop and ask for a box of 00 or 00 buckshot, people will probably know what you mean, but they'll likely have a chuckle over it after you leave. There are four Aught buckshot sizes, 32 caliber single Aught, 33 caliber double Aught, 36 caliber triple Aught, and 38 caliber quadruple Aught. Again, there's no consistent step between these sizes, and thus no simple formula, but they're not hard to remember. Most folks who are at all familiar with buckshot know that double Aught buck is 33 caliber. A trick for recalling the others is to start at 30 caliber and add 0.02 inches for each Aught. The Aughts offer more range and penetration than the numbered sizes at the expense of pellet count. They're primarily used in large bore 12 and 10 gauge shells, as they don't fit very well in smaller gauges. The most well known is double Aught buckshot. 9 double Aught pellets in a 2¾-inch 12-gauge shell is a classic combat load that famously proved itself in the trenches of World War I and is still a standard military load today. Double Aught is also widely used for hunting, often in magnum loads containing up to 18 pellets. Just 1/100th of an inch below double Aught, single Aught buck can offer very similar performance with less recoil, and in 12-gauge shells tends to be a better fit in cup-style wads that can improve patterning. Larger triple Aught and quadruple Aught buck loads have primarily been used for hunting due to their high penetration, heavy recoil, and poor packing efficiency. Triple Aught buckshot is common in 12-gauge shells, but factory quadruple Aught buck loads can be tough to find, though the shot itself is readily available from reloading suppliers. Triple Aught and quadruple Aught buckshot are also used in 410 shells. Since any buckshot size will only fit one at a time in these narrow shells, these large sizes make the most of the limited space and low muzzle velocities. The four numbered sizes and the four Aughts are the big eight of American buckshot. Nearly all mainstream factory buckshot ammo uses one of these sizes.
But for specialty ammo and hand loaders, there's a whole lot more to choose from. One noteworthy addition to the primary eight are the half sizes.
As we've seen, the differences between adjacent standard buckshot sizes is usually greater than 1/100th of an inch. Wherever there's a gap of 2/100ths or more, these named half sizes help fill those gaps. The naming convention for these half sizes is to add 1/2 to the next smallest whole buckshot size. This is intuitive enough for the Aughts. 34 caliber double Aught and a half is between double Aught and triple Aught,
and 37 caliber triple aught and a half would be between triple aught and quadruple aught. But for the numbered half sizes, the result is a little wonky because those numbers descend with size. Number 3.5 buckshot sounds like it should be between number 3 and number 4 buck somewhere, but since half sizes are named after the next smallest hole size, it actually sits between number 3 and number 2 buck at 0.26 inches in diameter. Likewise, 29 caliber number 2.5 buck is between number 2 and number 1, and 31 caliber number 1.5 buck is between number 1 and single aught. These half sizes are semi-official at best. I've yet to see these included in a SAMI publication or printed on commercial ammo packaging. But they are readily available for reloaders, and do a good job of filling in the gaps between the standard buckshot sizes. For hand loaders looking to fine-tune a custom buckshot load, these half sizes are worth learning about.
So we've added 5 more sizes, but we're still stuck in a pretty narrow range that tops out at 38 caliber. Is that it? Well, we have one last size system to go over, the ball sizes. Here we go, another weird old size system to remember, right? How does this one work?
Well, you take the diameter of the pellet, tack ball or round ball on the end, and that's a name.
Yes, with ball buckshot, we finally have a straightforward notation that doesn't require any math or memorization, and doesn't limit us to a specific number or range of sizes. This really opens up a lot of options, especially for hand loaders.
Smaller caliber balls provide additional choices between standardized sizes that are helpful for fine-tuning a custom load or better fitting a stack of pellets into a particular shell or wad. Larger ball sizes show up in some novelty and specialty shot shells such as duplex buck and ball loads or less lethal ammo containing large rubber or polymer balls. Shells containing 2 or 3 very large buckshot loaded single file are marketed for hunting very thick-skinned game like hogs.
Hunting laws can sometimes be fuzzy when it comes to very large ball sizes, so if you're in a buckshot-only area, do your homework.
Some of these ball sizes are marketed specifically as buckshot, but a lot more variety is available in balls sold as projectiles for muzzle-loading firearms. It may not say buckshot on the box, but a ball is a ball. Molds for casting round balls are also readily available in a variety of calibers, and you can special order ball molds in pretty much any custom sizes you can think of.
If you know your way around a mill or drill press, you can even create your own buckshot molds. Ginsboy 2003 has a nice detailed video on milling a custom multi-cavity buckshot mold.
Casting your own buckshot gives you more control over the alloy, and thus the hardness of the pellets. Many round balls on the market are made of pure lead, which is very soft and may not pattern well out of a shotgun. The upper limit on ball sizes, of course, is the bore diameter of the shotgun being used. However, bore size or near bore size lead balls, especially for the larger gauges, are so heavy that they're more commonly fired just one at a time in what's called a pumpkin ball load, which is actually a simple type of shotgun slug.
But we'll save slugs for another video. A couple closing notes before I wrap up here.
First, industry tolerances for buckshot are pretty wide, and the actual diameters of the pellets in commercial buckshot loads can vary quite a bit from the nominal diameter of the size printed on the box. Look for a future video with more detail on this. Second, large birdshot sizes can be used much like buckshot when hunting smaller, thin-skinned species like foxes or coyotes, especially if the pellets are made from something denser than lead. Because of this, lead or birdshot sizes are sometimes referred to or sold as buckshot. However, these sizes are still used on birds as well, and since they follow birdshot sizing conventions and are loaded by weight like birdshot, it's most accurate to classify them as such. Just don't get confused if you hear someone mention T or F buckshot. It's the same size as T and F birdshot.
So that's buckshot. Kind of a lot to take in, and much of it is hard to keep track of, but don't feel too overwhelmed. Until you get into advanced hand loading or real specialty ammo, you'll mostly just be dealing with these 8 standard sizes. If you can remember these, you'll be pretty well off. One last thing.
As I mentioned in the last video, I've never been able to find a single complete resource that includes every shot size. So, I've created my own original guide which can be viewed and downloaded free of charge at the link in the video description. This will be an exhaustive list of every pellet size I've ever heard of, with nominal diameters, approximate figures for pellet masses and counts, mathematical formulas, and other information.
I'll be updating this guide from time to time as I think of new features or come across new information, and I'll leave an annotation here with the date of the most recent version. Please let me know if you find any errors, or if there are other things you'd like to see me add. Well, I hope you all found this interesting. I could really talk about shotgun shot for hours, and I glossed over a lot of things in these videos to keep them focused. There will be many more shot-related videos in future installments of this series, so if there's something in particular you'd like to see me explain in detail, please let me know. And of course, questions and feedback are always welcome.
Until next time, have fun, shoot safely and responsibly, and encourage others to do the same.